Hello. I thought I'd talk today about files. Many of us get files from our students. They turn them in as homework, and we can't open them. It can be a very frustrating thing. You'll see on the left side of this screen, I've got three different icons representing files, and the first one looks like it's going to open with Word, and the second one looks like it may be opening with Notepad, and the third one, we just don't know. Let's see what we can do about this. So I guess the first thing you realize is that the problem may not be as bad as you think. Many of us, of course, when we want to open up a file, we just double-click on the file to open it. But the question is, how does your computer know which program it should use to view the file you double-clicked on? Does it know to open it in Word or Excel or Paint or even iTunes? How do we know this? Well, we're going to go into the world of a geek here for a second, so just hold on. We need to talk about file extensions. In the PC world, file names end with a period and some letters. For example, in the picture here, you can see .doc. That's a file extension. .xls, .html. There's a whole bunch of these. And file extensions are the key to know which programs will open which files for you. On your computer, you may not even be able to see file extensions. This is a default setting. You can see on the screenshot here on the left side, I can see a file named Difficult Student. But I can't tell if that's a .doc, .docx, or who knows what. I can't see it. But on the screenshot on the right side, I have changed my computer so I'm allowed to see file extensions. And I can see that those both are .doc files. And that's important for me to know that little piece of information. So how do you do this? Well, you can tell your computer to quit hiding file extensions. If you go to the Start menu and your Control Panels and find something called Folder Options. When you open up Folder Options, click on the View tab near the top, and there's a whole bunch of settings in there. But one of them is called Hide Extensions for Known File Types, and that is probably checked, so it is hiding them. If you uncheck it and then click OK, you will stop hiding file extensions, and now you'll be able to see them. So that's the first trick, I think, be able to see your file extensions. So once you see your file extensions, how does your computer know that anything ending in .doc should open with Word? How does your computer know that .mp3 files maybe should be open with iTunes? How does it know .anything opens with anything? Now, sometimes your computer may not even know how to open a particular file up. Why does this happen? Sometimes you'll see an icon like the one shown on the left here, and this is the dreaded unknown file icon. Windows doesn't know what to do with it. You double-click on it, and the dialog box on the right pops up, and at that point, most of us just give up and say, "I can't open the file." So let's see how this works. We're going to have to return to this geek zone again for a second here, so hang on. And we're going to return back to that same control panel we had opened before. Start, Settings, Control Panel, and the Folder Options Control Panel. This time we're going to look at a different tab, though, called File Types. The File Types tab is where we can see which file extensions are associated with which computer programs. Scroll around a bit and look at this, and I do want to give you a warning. Don't mess in here unless you're pretty sure what you're doing. So if you're not sure, always click Cancel to get out of the dialog box. But let's take a look at this in real life now. Here on the screen, you can see the Folder Options Control Panel, and I've clicked on the File Types tab. And at first, it frankly doesn't make too much sense. You have to scroll down a little bit to finally get to some interesting information. So here, for example, you'll see a file extension of .3g2. I don't even know what that is, to tell you the truth. But as I go down, they get a little more interesting. They're in alphabetical order based on the file extension, and the little icons to the left usually mean something. So let's see if I can find something a little more interesting. Here's one here, a .asf. I don't even know what that means, frankly. If I click on it, though, down in the bottom of this window, you'll see that that is set so that it will automatically open with Windows Media Player. And that's been set up by the computer. I haven't done anything. If I look at another one, let's try a .asp. This one opens with blank. The computer doesn't know what to do with it. And you notice the icon to the left is the unknown file type icon. So the computer has no idea how to deal with that. As we go through these, let me see if I can find something a little more interesting. Here's a .doc. Now we know those open with Microsoft Word, and you can see the confirmation of this. It's going to open it with Microsoft Word. The little icon looks correct, and the program that it's used to open it. So let's find another file type that your student may be turning into you. I'm going to look down through the list and try to find RTFs. Here you'll see near the top RTF, and a little icon next to it, and that's not a Word icon next to it. If I go down to the bottom, it says open with WordPad, and that may be fine, or it may not be what you want. Now I know that I can open an RTF file up with Word. I'm very confident in that will work for me. If you're not confident in doing this, do not do it. So I'm going to actually change the file association for this. I'm going to make RTFs open with Word. So you'll see to the right there's a button for change. I'm going to click on that. And it says Windows can't deal with this, what do you want to do? I'm going to select the program from a list of computer programs on my computer. I'll click OK, and there'll be a whole list of these, and I can browse the hard drive should I want to, but when I look, I do see the choice for Microsoft Office Word. I like that one. I'm always going to use that to open this type of file, an RTF, and I'll click OK. Now you notice the entry has changed in the control panel. I have a little Word icon, and down below it says opens with Microsoft Office Word, and I'll click Close. And at this point now, whenever I double click on an RTF file, it will open in Word for me. And now you can see in this screenshot the original three files I showed you at the very beginning. One had the Word icon on the left side, one had the notepad icon, and one had the unknown icon, because that was an RTF file. Now on the right side you can see the same icons, and you can see that the RTF file has now been associated with Word, and if I double click on it, it'll open with Word. Now what if in all of this you're just not a geek, and as soon as I said go to the control panel and open this and click here and do that, you just said no way, I'm not doing it. There are some other ways you can get around this problem. Let's say your student turns in an RTF file, and you know you should probably be able to open that with Word. Let's say they turn in a .txt file, and you're feeling pretty comfortable. I should be able to open that with Word. Perhaps even they turned in a WordPerfect file, and you're thinking, I think Word can open that. There are ways to trick Word to at least try to open the file, so let me show you how to do that. The pictures on the left here show two examples of what a student may have turned into you. Even if your computer does not show file extensions, what it is not showing is file extensions it knows what to do something with. So in this case, the computer does not know what to do with the top one whose file extension is .wps. Therefore, it will show the file extension. It also doesn't know what to do with the bottom one, the .wpd. They both show the unknown file icon, so that's another clue for me. Now I know that the top one is actually a Microsoft Works formatted document, and I figure Word should be able to open it. The second one is a WordPerfect document, and I'm thinking Word should be able to open that as well. How do I know what those file extensions are? Well, I've messed with computers enough to be familiar with them, but you can also search the internet for file extensions and find out what they are. So let me show you what I might do with these using Microsoft Word. I am in Word right now. I'm in Word version 2003, but it'll work the same in 2007 or 2010. And what I want to do is open up a file that my students turned in. So I'm going to choose File Open. Now you notice I started Microsoft Word. If I double click on those files that are of unknown type, the dialog will pop up with the operating system telling me it doesn't know what to do, and I'm just kind of stuck at that point. So the trick here is to start up Word first, and then do File Open. And I've got my student homework files in a folder. And if you notice right now, what is showing are two files, .doc and .rtf. Now again, I have file extensions showing, so this is helping me. But where's all the rest of my homework files? I know there were more than this, more than two. Where they disappeared? Well, not really. If you look at the bottom of this dialog box, Microsoft is trying to help me, and it's only showing files that Word knows how to deal with. .doc files, .dot, .rtf, because I told it to handle those earlier. So where are the rest of the files? Well, what I have to do is tell Word to quit filtering for me. Instead of showing just Word documents, show me everything in this folder. All files. I don't care if they're movies, pictures, sound files. I don't care. Show them all to me. And if I do that, more things pop up. And I can see now I have a .txt file, a .wps, and up at the top even my WordPerfect file is here. So I'm thinking Word should be able to open a works file. So I'm going to try it. I'm going to click on it and click open. And there it is. I opened up a works file just like that. The WordPerfect file should work very similar. I do file open, navigate to where the file is, make sure I'm looking at all files so I can see it, click on it, and open it. I hope this helps you.